This is Eyewitness News HealthBeat.
It is estimated that 700,000 Hoosiers live with diabetes, and it's estimated more than 1.6 million people in our state have pre-diabetes. So this week's Ask the Nutritionist segment focuses on food for diabetics. This is Mary Snell. She's a nutritionist from Marsh, and she's with us every week. Good to have you here again, Mary.
Hi, Scott. I brought some interesting things today.
Yeah, and we're talking sugar-free, and this comes, of course, the day after Halloween.
Exactly, of course. Well, a lot of people, certainly, that are going to be diagnosed with diabetes are going to think, well, I've got to eliminate sugar out of my diet. There's a lot of products on the market that are sugar-free, but what I always recommend to my customers and patients, read the label. Because since it is sugar-free, it still has calories, it still has carbohydrates, and those are still two important things that people still have to manage in their diabetes diet.
So if I go into a store and I'm diabetic and I reach for the sugar-free product, I may be thinking I can eat as many as I want, but that's not the case.
That's not really the case. I've got a couple examples here that can show you. I've got a sugar-free cookie product and sort of the other counterpart that has the sugar in it. You'll notice that the calorie content is not that significantly different. And the carbohydrate content, which is really important for diabetics also, it's not significantly different. So it's not, sugar-free doesn't mean it's a free-for-all, and it doesn't mean it shouldn't be counted into your diet. It really does have to be worked into a person's diet.
Interesting, too, if we're snacking on mints, you're really not better off doing the sugar-free,
are
you?
No, look at this product. I've got, again, the regular counterpart versus a sugar-free peppermint patty, and look at the difference. The sugar-free product actually has more calories. And, you know, people are thinking, well, the sugar's out. Where do the calories come from? There's actually more fat, and it's the unhealthy fat in the sugar-free product. And that's not really good for diabetics as well. So it really does mean look at the label, compare calories, and compare carbohydrate content.
Sugar-free cake as well.
Yes. Here again, you'll notice that the calorie content is not that significantly different. And again, I'm not condoning we should, you know, consume the product that has a sugar in it. What I am suggesting is that the carbohydrate content needs to be considered as part of the whole diet package.
What should the whole diet package be for diabetics?
It's a good question. You know, for years and years, we always said, okay, you can't have this, you have to avoid this. But really the philosophy is eating a balanced diet of fruits and vegetables and dairy products, lean proteins and whole grains. And working with a dietitian certainly who can work with the person's individual eating habits, exercise activity, and really structure a diet that meets their needs.
Marsh also has some free diabetic medicines, right?
We really do. We actually offer about 7 free oral diabetic medications. And that's just really our way, certainly, of providing some assistance for individuals who might be financially struggling with this, managing this disease.
Excellent. Mary Snell is with Marsh. She's with us every week here on the news. It's great to be with you again today. And
thanks,
thank you,
Scott,
again for helping us understand this as well. Huge excitement already for the number one ranked